To get regular updates, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon.
Hello friends, this is Dipali Shah from Examine. This is the next part in our video series of Indian Polity. If you have not watched the previous lesson on the salient features of Indian Constitution, the link is given in the below description. Do watch that first and then continue with this lesson. Before getting into this lesson, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and get the regular updates. Let's get started. Preamble and Citizenship. Preamble of Indian Constitution. The preamble to the Constitution of India is a brief introductory statement that sets out the guiding purposes, principles and philosophy of the Indian Constitution. Preamble gives the idea of the following: the source of the Constitution, nature of Indian state, a statement of its objective and the date of its adoption. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution. We, the people of India. The phrase "we, the people of India" emphasizes that the Constitution is made by and for the Indian people and has not given to them by any outside power. It also emphasizes the concept of the popular sovereignty as laid down by Rosaro. All the power emerges from the people and the political system will be accountable and responsible to the people. Nature of Indian state. Sovereign. India is internally and externally sovereign, which means that India is externally free from the control of any foreign power, and internally it has a free government which is directly elected by the people and makes law that govern the people. No external power can dictate the government of India. Socialist. Socialism is an economic philosophy where means of production and distribution are owned by the state. India adopted a mixed economy where apart from the state, there will be private production too. Socialism as a social philosophy stresses on more on the societal equality. Secular. Features of secularism as envisaged in the preamble is to mean that the state will have no religion of its own and all the persons will be equally entitled to the freedom of conscience and right freely to profess, practice and propagate the religion of their choice. Democratic. Democratic indicates that the Constitution has established a form of government which gets its authority from the will of the people. The rulers are elected by the people and are responsible to them. Republic. As opposed to a monarchy in which the head of the state is appointed on a hereditary basis for a lifetime or until he abdicates from the throne, a democratic republic is an entity in which the head of the state is elected directly or indirectly for a fixed tenure. The President of India is elected by an electoral college for a term of 5 years. The post of the President of India is not hereditary. Every citizen of India is eligible to become the President of the country. Objectives of the Indian state: justice, social, economic and political, equality of status and opportunity, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. Date of its adoption. Date of adoption of the Constitution is 26th November 1949, but most of its articles in Constitution came into force on the January 26, 1950. Those articles which came into existence on 26th November 1949 is given by Article 394. Article 394 states that this article and articles 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 60, 324, 366, 367, 379, 380 and 388, 391, 392 and 393 shall come into force at once, and the remaining provision of this Constitution shall come into force on the 26th day of January 1950, which day is referred to in this Constitution as the commencement of this Constitution. 26th January was selected for this purpose because it was this day in 1930 when the Declaration of Indian Independence, Purna Swaraj, was proclaimed by the Indian National Congress. Citizenship in India and Indian Citizenship Act. Fundamental rights provided in Indian Constitution are available to the citizens of India only. Some of the fundamental rights which are not enjoyed by non-citizens of India are right to be discriminated on the basis of religion, race, gender and caste or birthplace, equal opportunities in public employment, right of six democratic freedom of the Article 19 and cultural and educational rights. Only the citizens of India have right to hold the civil office, right to vote and right to be judges of the courts. Indian Citizenship Act 1955. Indian Constitution provides single citizenship to all irrespective of a state a person belongs to. Constitution simply describes classes of people deemed to be citizen of India as on 26 January 1950 and leaves the entire law of citizenship to be regulated by the parliamentary laws. The Parliament has enacted Indian Citizenship Act 1955 for acquisition and loss of Indian citizenship. Since its commencement, it has been amended four times: the Citizenship Amendment Act 1986, the Citizenship Amendment Act 1992, the Citizenship Amendment Act 2003, the Citizenship Amendment Act 2005. According to the Indian Citizenship Act 1955, Indian citizenship was extended to citizens of Commonwealth countries, but this law was repealed by the amendment in 2003. Acquisition of Indian citizenship as per the Citizenship Act 1955. Citizenship by birth. Every person who is born in India on or after January 26, 1950 shall be a citizen of India by birth. Citizenship by descent. A person born outside India on or after January 26, 1950 shall be a citizen of India by descent if either of his parents is a citizen of India at the time of the person's birth. Citizenship by registration. A person can acquire Indian citizenship by registering themselves before the prescribed authority. Example, persons of Indian origin who are ordinarily resident in India and have been so for 5 years immediately before making the application for registration. Persons who are married to the citizens of India is another example. Citizenship by naturalization. Naturalization, which is a legal process by which a citizen of one country becomes the citizen of another. A foreigner can acquire Indian citizenship on application of naturalization to the government of India. Citizenship by incorporation of territory. If any new territory becomes a part of India, the government of India shall specify the person of that territory as the citizens of India. Termination of Indian citizenship. Renunciation by voluntary act. After acquiring the citizenship of another country, deprivation of citizenship by an order of the government of India. With this, we have come to the end of this session, and in the next session, we would be seeing about the overseas citizenship of India, persons of Indian origin card and much more. Stay tuned to the exam band by subscribing to our channel notifications. Thank you.